Now, it's a little bit beyond the scope of the class for me to actually show you how to find the direction of maximal variance. It involves some linear algebra, which isn't too difficult, but we're not going to get into here. But if you're willing to believe me that the principal component, the direction of maximal variance, can be found, I can justify to you that that's the direction that's going to minimize the information loss. Now let's look at the neighborhood information for our housing data. This is my data that I have available to me. On one axis, I have the number of safety problems in a given neighborhood. On the other axis, I have the school ranking of that neighborhood. And I'm going to use PCA to combine these two features into a single feature that I'll say is roughly gauging the quality of the neighborhood. So just by visually inspecting the data, we can see that something like this red line is going to be the principal component. Then when I project down the two-dimensional points onto this one-dimensional line, I'm going to be losing information. And the amount of information that I lose is equal to the distance between a given point as it existed in this sort of 2D space and its new spot on the line. So for this blue point here, an amount of information that's roughly equal to the length of this yellow line is the amount of information that I lose. So here's a little quiz to make sure you understand. I'm circling a point in green here, and this point is going to be projected down onto the principal component as well, like all the other points in this data set eventually. So my question for you is, how much information are we going to be losing when we perform that projection of this point? Is it going to be more, less, or about equal to the amount of information that's lost on our original point, this example that I just showed you?